Good morning, everyone. You hear me over my plan here? Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Hey, it's so great to see you all here. I want to extend a special welcome to all of our guests that I see with us. I want to let you know that you're welcome here at Prairie Bible Church. So the good news is that although God doesn't need us to help him, he wants us to help him. He wants us to be his missionaries throughout the world and to spread his gospel. And one of the things that we do most often to help spread the gospel is we pray to advance the kingdom. And so would you please stand and join us? Let's sing about all of the wonderful things that happen as we pray.
Good Sunday morning to everyone. Welcome to Prairie Bible Church. We are thrilled that you're able to be here and looking forward to a great chance to worship together this morning and celebrate our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As a reminder, Prairie Bible Church believes our mission is to help people grow in their faith by being a simple and authentic representation of Jesus' love. We hope that we can do that here this morning and each and every day as we go out into our community, into our world. If you are new to Prairie Bible Church or newer, welcome. We're thrilled that you're able to find us and be with us and hope that you feel very comfortable this morning and are looking forward to being with us. And want to mention that out on the tables in the hallways, there's some simple brochures that even if you aren't new and you want to take one of these, please do so. It just gives a little bit of info about who we are as PBC and how we're trying to impact our world and our community here. And if you have someone maybe that you think of that you're going to interact with in the next week, that would be great to just share with them an opportunity that they might have in the community. Take one. Put it on their desk or mail it to them or drop it off in the mailbox so people can know what's going on here at PBC. The other thing I want to do is welcome anybody that's worshiping online with us. We know that there are great people that are there and are a part of this family as well. And I would ask if everybody would be willing, as we kind of do periodically, is to welcome them all into service. So if you would stand and wave to the camera there above the door and welcome them to service this morning as well. It is awesome to know how many people that on a weekly basis, there might be 20, 40, 80 people watching live at the same time that we are here in the building. And so you're just as big a part of this service and want to welcome you in as well. We've got a few things going on in the next couple weeks, and I want to make sure we highlight. One is a small group study. If you are not new to PBC and you've been here before and you don't know about this, turn on your ears because we've been talking about it for a month now. Pastor Craig, the next 6 weeks, is going to be preaching on the book study called When the Game's Over, It All Goes Back in the Box. This is the study guide. They're back on the back table. We hope that everybody will pick up a study guide. There's a lot of life groups and small groups that are going to be going through the guides in the next 6 weeks as well, and we'd love it if you're doing that. If you're a life group or you're not in a life group and you're not doing it, there's some signups on the back table of some groups that you could join, even just for the next 6 weeks, to get that experience. The nice thing is you can do this on your own. Come to service and just go through this book on your own, and we hope that you will do that at least. But there's also a DVD video that goes along with it that the life groups are going to be watching and then discussing in that small group setting. So hopefully that's a chance that you can do that and be involved. Again, if you got questions, grab Pastor Craig, find me after service. We'd be happy to get people plugged in a way to do that. The other thing I want to mention this morning is we are privileged this morning to have a guest that's going to be joining us during service. I'm not going to spill the beans. I think some people know already that Bridget Under the Bridge, that wonderful service that's going on in our community, and I'm not going to talk a lot more about that, but she is here today to talk a little bit more about what's going on, how she's been able to serve our community, and maybe how we can then even partner with her. With that, one of the ways we can do that, and there's a lot of ways to give and serve it to our Lord and Savior, but one of them is through financial giving. As all of you know, we've got our miracle bar on the back table that any week, as you feel called to give to God, part of the blessings that he's given to you, we ask that you just give there to PBC. And remember that 10% of all giving to PBC, then we give to missions. And one of those missions is Bridget Under the Bridge. But also today, because she's here and we're able to worship with her, we've got a special love offering, we've called it, right next to the barn. And so if you want to give directly to that, it's a great way to do that this morning. We'll talk about that more later, but I wanted to preview that as a great opportunity this morning for everyone. The other thing I want to mention this morning that has been happening recently is in January, our leadership team here at PBC had a little retreat to talk about where we feel God is leading us in the next month, 6 months, 12 months, and more in our communities and how we can grow. And one of the biggest things that came out of that time together was the fact that great programming doesn't mean anything in a church. True ministry happens from the heart. True ministry happens from the Spirit. And when God is moving in each and every one of us to make great ministry in our communities. And when you have when you feel a passion, when you feel God calling on you and nudging on you to do something in the community to help someone else, we've got to listen. We've got to pay attention to that. And we kind of, as a leadership team, said that's how we see Prairie Bible growing. Not by what we think and what we can put on an organizational chart and an outline, but when we feel the Spirit moving in individual people, allowing them to let that go, let that passion run. So over the next few months, as we have people that feel those passions and want to share what they're going to do and how they're going to live into that, we want to share it with all of you so that we can all be involved. Some ways we can maybe get involved and help them walk side by side. Other ways it may be just pray with them. But that's what we're going to look at. We've got one this morning to kind of talk about a passion and where she feels like it could be leading Prairie Bible. We got a video for it.
Hello, family. My name is Shannon. Lately, God has been putting it on my heart, the desire to encourage you, my brothers and sisters, to get into the Word. In this holy book, which was put to paper starting in the time of Moses, is God's heart and His wisdom for us. But it's not just ink and paper. It's quite literally active and alive with the help of the Holy Spirit guiding us when we read. In these pages, our truth, our history, God's plan for us, the depth of His love for us, help for today, and hope for our tomorrows. Over the centuries, theologians fought so that each one of us could have our Bible in our own languages, so that we could worship God in our own time. Many of them paid for this with their lives, gladly. Why? Because they understood the raw power that exists in these pages. They knew that God speaks to each of us with the real-time power of the Holy Spirit when we read seeking Him. They knew that putting God's word directly before our eyes held such power for God that not only would He be glorified, but that we would be strengthened, comforted, enlightened, and wrapped in the consuming love of our Creator. They knew that every time God's word is read or spoken, it wins a battle against the devil. The history of the beginning of the universe, the prophecy and plan for our eternity, and in between our songs, prayers, true stories, poems, instructions, redemption, salvation, comfort, and joy. We all need all of those things right now in great measure. And thankfully, they're all readily available and free right here. A group of us from Prairie Bible Church that all share this same passion met a couple of weeks ago and discussed ways that we might encourage our body to get into the Word more. One of the things that we developed is a small 6-week program where we're going to provide a few facts and tidbits that'll hopefully encourage you and inspire you to genuinely want to get into the Word and read it by yourself or in small groups on a daily basis and sink deeper and deeper into God's love. I know that it will glorify Him and it will bless you greater than you ever could have imagined. I can speak to that truth myself. So look for these tidbits called Bible, Did You Know, on the back of the sermon notes the next 6 weeks during Lent. Thank you, everybody.
Simple, authentic Jesus. And that's what we want to continue to share in a lot of different ways. So as each of you have that passion that you can hear Shannon got, and the Holy Spirit was knocking on her to be able to share, that's what we want to do as a family in Christ, to be able to do that. And just as a reminder, she mentioned on the sermon notes here every week, there'll be the Bible Did You Know, one little line in there that we can all be watching and following. We're looking forward to how the Spirit's going to move us in the next 6 to 12 to 24 months. Would you join me in an opening prayer, please? Dear Heavenly Father, I thank You for the chance to come together this morning with Your people, Your family, Your sons and daughters, my brothers and sisters in Christ, Lord, that we can come together to worship You and to love You in this space. I thank You for the past week and the joys and the opportunities that each and every one of us has had to live in Your world and to not take for granted the many blessings that You give all of us each and every day. To live in this country, to have jobs to go to spaces to be. We know that there's many brothers and sisters around the world that don't have those wonderful gifts. I thank You, Lord, for where You brought us. And I pray, Lord, that as we come into this space this morning, the challenges that might come and the problems that have come from the past week, that You would help us to put those aside. We ask, Lord, that you would just allow us to focus on you, how awesome you are in our world, and that you would allow us to just devote ourselves to you the next 60 minutes. No other distractions, no other issues, but to pour our heart and our soul into you as you so graciously deserve. Pray for this time, Lord, that the music we sing would bring glory and joy to your ears as we worship. And pray that the words that we hear would fill us with your spirit and ignite in us a wonderful spirit to go out and share and love and minister in the world. I pray for those that aren't here with us this morning in body, that they would be here in spirit, know that they are loved and that they're just as much a part of this space and this people and this ministry as we all are. And I pray, Lord, as we do so often, that you would guide us, guide our steps, guide our words, guide our actions this coming week, that we would go as you would have us to go to spread your love and your light in this world. We ask all this in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
I love what Shannon just said about God's word. And one of the things that God's word tells us is that God has made a way for us. Do you believe God's made a way for us this morning? Do you believe that the way... Amen. Do you believe that way is Jesus?
Oh, yeah.
Amen. All right. So, since God has made a way for us, he deserves nothing but praise from us because we didn't deserve a way, but he gave it to us anyway. So, would you please stand if you're able, and let's acknowledge the beauty of our wonderful Savior, Jesus Christ, and the way that he did make.
Hallelujah.
Worship you. Worship.
He's a promise keeper, a way maker. And speaking of God's word, God's word has a lot to say about not only the fact that God loves us, but that he wants us to love each other. And this week I'll be sharing the same scripture I was sharing last week, except for last week was Valentine's Day, and we focused on God's immense love for us, a love so great that it's overwhelming, that we can't measure it because it's so awesome. And what we do when we receive that love is we take it and we do our very humanly best to show it to other people. And that's what our scripture acknowledges as well. I'll have the words up on the screens behind me. I encourage you to read along with me. It says, "In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be a propitiation for our sins." Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us. As a matter of fact, the world is going to know that God has loved us and that we love God because of our love for each other. So let's all sing that together. So much. You may be seated.
All right. Welcome, guys. Good to see you. All right, I brought our paper chain up, and I was the recipient of a couple different photos this week. I saw your guys' paper chains at home. Thank you for sending photos, and my friend Bryn, I have to say hi to Bryn on the camera. She sent me one, too, and I haven't seen Bryn for a long time, so it's so good to see her. and she had made her paper chain. And so I want to take just a second to talk about sometimes our paper chains. There's some tricky stuff in here. Have you guys been reading this week? Each day has a verse on it. And we dig in and we see what God has to say. And there was one I was going to read for you guys that you, I think you read on Thursday or Friday. And this verse, it says, this is in Isaiah 53, verse 6. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Sometimes when we read a verse, the words kind of go in and then they go out. We want to capture those words. And sometimes when there's a lot of vocabulary in there, like those are big words that we don't always understand, we need help, don't we? And some of us, we read with a parent. Some of us read on our own. But I wanted to share three tips for you guys. As you're taking a new piece of your chain off and you're reading and you're capturing God's words, they're all pointing to Jesus. So tip number one. Tip number one is we like hard things. Can you guys say that with me? We like hard things. There are some hard things, but we know that God takes those hard things and grows our brain. It's through those hard things that we are grown into mature Christians. It's through the hard things that we know God more. So we like hard things. Two, are we on our own? Never. No, there's a great promise. I want to read you guys from James 1. And this is what he says. This is what God says. If any of you lacks wisdom, that's that smart brain that can figure out what's going on. If any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, and it will be given to him. Do you know that God gives wisdom to Katie as well as God gives wisdom to our friend Ron Bunch? God gives wisdom to little people and big people just where you're at. So what did our Bible say? Did God promise to give us wisdom? So one, we like hard things. Two, we ask God and he gives us wisdom. And number three, get a friend or a parent to help you work through the hard pieces of scripture. And when you work together, and sometimes there's a big word like at the end of that verse I read for you, that word iniquity, that might not be in your everyday vocabulary. What shall we do? We ask an adult. We ask Siri. We ask Google. And we find the definition to the hard word. And then God helps us and grows our minds. Can you guys pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, I just ask that you anoint these sweet brains with wisdom. Show them your way and grow them at just the right speed, in just the right place, so that they can know you and your Son and the gift of Jesus even more. And all God's children said, amen.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, there's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus. Like the sunshine after the rain. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, let all heaven and earth proclaim. Kings and kingdoms will all pass away. But there'll still be something about that name.
Lord, I want to thank you so much for just being Jesus to us. Knowing that you, oh God, loved us so much that you would give us Jesus, that you would become one of us, that you would die on the cross and you would rise again on the third day, Lord, that we might not only have hope, but that you might demonstrate your grace and your mercy, and that you might fill us with purpose. Our hope is because you have gained victory over sin and death. When you rose from that grave, you said, devil, get out of here. You said, my people have victory today. Our responsibility as your people is to claim it. And that's what I'm praying that we will do. I'm praying, Jesus, that you will help us to embrace the grace and the truth that you are, and that we might live it for a world that needs to know that those things are available to them too. I thank you, Jesus, that not only have you given us grace and truth, you've also given us meaning and purpose. That this life isn't just about us. In fact, it's not about us anymore at all. It's about you, and it's about being you to the world, being Jesus to the world. And I pray, Lord, that sometimes just the immensity of that truth is overwhelming. And I'm praying, Savior, that you would help us this morning to understand the simple and authentic way in which you have called each of us to be Jesus to the world. We claim the promise found in Isaiah 55:11. This says, truly when it is your words that go out, that shall not come back empty. And my prayer this morning, Jesus, is that all the words that are spoken will be your words. I'm praying, Lord Jesus, that your Holy Spirit would just dump on us and that we would be anointed in a beautiful and inspiring way. I pray, Lord, that you'll show us how we have been called to be the church together, and that you would show us how we have been called to be the church in and of ourselves, individually as well. I thank you for Bridget and her family and the testimony of faith that they are, and their willingness to use their gifts and graces to be Jesus to the world as well. Show us this morning, Lord, not only how we can be an encouragement to them, but how you might use us to step up alongside of them, knowing that we are called to do this thing together. We are called to be Jesus to the world together. So thank you, Lord. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for a day like this where we can freely gather. There's no one or nothing that's stopping us to gather, whether it be here in person or online, to be the church and to offer you the worship and the praise that you deserve. We pray these things in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Good morning, everybody. I want you to know I am thrilled to be here. My wife was driving through a blizzard this week, and I wondered whether I would be here because I was sitting in the passenger seat as she was driving through. Y'all know that if you've been a part of Prairie Bible for any length of time, you know that it is our heart's desire to be a simple and authentic representation of Jesus to the world, right? And because of that, we believe that the Bible teaches what? That there are three things. There are lots of ways in which we are called to be Jesus to the world, to be authentic representation to the world, but we know that there are three general categories that every Christian is called to live into. We are called to worship God, right? And worshiping God is not something that you do only on Sunday mornings. Worshiping God is what we are called to do with our lives. Every breath that you breathe is intended to be an act of worship. Is that the way you live your life? Is that the way you breathe? I'll be honest with you. That is not what I think every breath I breathe, but I should, and so should you. Every breath can be an act of worship. If the intimacy that we have with Jesus is that close, you can feel it. You can know it. We are called to worship. We are also called, according to the Bible, to something called discipleship. We are called to grow as disciples, and we are called to make disciples. That's not complicated. Basically, a disciple is a follower. We are called to follow Jesus and to call others to follow Jesus. It's not complicated. Not easy, but it's not complicated either. The last category, if you will, of our calling is to serve God by serving the world. Remember, it's always all about God. But when God calls us to serve Him, what He's really saying is, you're going to serve me by serving them. Now, there are, again, I alluded a moment ago that there are lots of wonderful, nuanced ways in which we can choose to serve God. Some of you served God this morning by being greeters at the door. Beautiful. Thank you for doing that, by the way. There are some that serve God by teaching Bible studies. But let me tell you something, and you need to listen to me very clearly here. Because churches, Christians, fall into this trap all the time. We believe, or we act as though this is the church, that this is our calling. And if we make the mistake of never taking our service beyond these doors, we have failed fundamentally at what God has called us to be as the church. Because guess what? Even though there are folks that will come in through these doors that we have opportunity to minister to, there's going to be far more that we have been called to serve that will never come through these doors. So we need to be so intimately in love with Jesus to say, Lord, how are you calling me to be Jesus out there? Not just in here. How are you calling me, us, to be Jesus out there? And today, if you've ever asked yourself that question, today we're going to give you an example of how we are called, the church is called, to be Jesus to the world. Started during the duratio, right, Bridget? Yeah, that's when the Holy Spirit fell on you guys, and God said, it's time to get out there, right? Time to get out there. And there was some folks from our church, when we heard about what God was doing through Bridget and her family, there was some folks from our church that said, we're to get out there and be Jesus with Bridget and her family. And as time went by, we thought, you know what? Y'all need to hear what's going on. You need to meet this family. First of all, just to know what God is doing. Second of all, hopefully to be an inspiration to you about how God may be calling you to be Jesus to the world. So, Jess, if you bring out that stool, I would like you all, if you would, to give a big round of applause to Bridget Williams as she comes up, and we're going to share just a little bit together today. You can take your mask off if you like. If you want to leave it on, that's okay. Bridget loves talking in front of people. But I put her heart at ease. If you're struggling to talk, I like to talk in front of people. So we make a great team, right? Right. Bridget, I am thrilled that you're here. And it's not just you that's here this morning, right? Would you tell us a little, hold the mic right up there. Tell us a little bit about yourself and about your whole family, would you? You guys want to come up? Come up here. Come on out. You just roll through. Yeah, hold it right up here. They don't want to leave the prayer room because there's donuts and milk and juice. Come on out, you guys. Just come out real quickly. Just roll on through. Here comes your dad. Come right up this way. Give me a high five. Keep right on coming. You know your mom. You come right over here.
So Bishop.
Jeremiah.
Jameson.
Are you guys twins? I called you Jeremiah? Jeremias. Braylon. Javonte Jr. Charlie. Hey, BJ. Hey, man. Charlie, hey, give me five. Give me five. Yeah. Woo. Hey, Charlie, did you get a donut? Do you like donuts? Did you eat a donut too? I love donuts. I am thrilled you guys came. Is there still any donuts and stuff left in there? Whoa, there we go. Now, if you want to stay up here and do, like, just hang out, you can. Otherwise, you can go back to the donuts and the juice. What you want to do? You know, I don't blame you.
It wasn't a hard decision.
That was not a hard decision. Good job, you guys. Thank you. You have a wonderful family, by the way.
Thank you.
You got a big family, too. I don't know if you noticed that.
Someday.
Some days you notice that, right?
Someday.
Yeah, yeah.
When you start cooking and there's no leftovers.
Uh-huh. Lisa called Bridget last night and they were visiting a little bit and she goes, How do you get all the kids together? And she goes, oh, I'm starting tonight, right? You started last night getting them ready for this morning. Well, we're glad that you came and glad that you entertained the process with it. Are there things that, what about you? Did you grow up here in Cedar Rapids? Or?
We're all from Illinois.
All from Illinois?
Awesome.
How did you end up in Cedar Rapids?
His sister moved here, and she told us nothing but good things.
Oh.
And we were struggling.
Yeah. Really?
Five of those.
Hold that mic right up there close. Lisa's old. She can't hear things, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
The twins were babies.
So, I remember part of you telling, I don't remember if it was you or Jolene that told me part of your story, but it was that because you had been homeless for 8 months, you when the derecho hit, you thought, God, we gotta do something, right?
Yeah. Okay.
There you go. That's
good.
See,
now I can hear myself.
There we go. So tell us about that. How did that all begin to happen? I mean, how did you?
It was just knowing that being a mom,
yeah,
and not being able to provide, it touches you in a different way.
Yeah.
So when you see all your neighbors and you hear about the community, we actually walked from our house right after the storm. Mm-hmm. We walked from our house all the way to, I don't know if anybody knows where, Hy-Vee on First Avenue is.
Mm-hmm.
We walked, me and my kids walked, and it's about 4 miles.
Yeah.
Just to see the destruction.
Yeah.
I mean, we couldn't drive. Our car was in front of a tree, so, you know. But we just wanted to see, like, what actually had happened.
Yeah.
It was bad.
It was. In fact, some of it's still out there, right?
It's still bad,
yeah.
And once we got home, we just decided that there was a reason for us to be able to help.
Mm.
And we were going to do it.
That is the Holy Spirit. It really is. The Holy Spirit was speaking to you saying, not only do we have a heart for this, but we have a purpose in this, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. You, at the time when that happened, right, you started feeling God wants us to help somehow. One of the things that you discovered was you were out of electricity, and all of a sudden you saw that as a opportunity, right? Why was being out of electricity an opportunity? Can you turn my mic down a little bit, please?
Yeah. We had $800 worth of meat in our freezer.
Because that was all going to spoil, right?
It was going to spoil.
If something wasn't done, so a catastrophe actually became an opportunity, right?
Yes. Yes.
So what did you decide to do, obviously?
So we called his dad, and we said, we need a grill. Everybody has a charcoal grill.
Yeah.
We need something that's going to do more than just this.
Yeah.
And we went and got a flat top, and you can do anything on it. You could put a pot on it and boil a pot of water.
Mm-hmm.
So we were making spaghetti. We were making macaroni and cheese. We were making, sandwiches, everything.
Mm-hmm.
And people started to come. Mm-hmm. You know, we had
so
our
did
kids.
You just go? Did you just set up down there under the bridge and just
we
say,
just
and then
up.
Just thought, Lord, bring the people?
Yep.
I mean, you didn't advertise or anything, right?
Well, we had the kids. They made some free food signs.
That's good, right?
They thought that was a cool idea.
Yeah.
So they made some signs.
So you got the kids involved, too,
oh,
didn't
yeah.
you? Yeah.
I mean, it was 90 degrees.
Yeah.
And there was no lights. There was nothing but just us.
Yeah.
So we made a way.
Amen. 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 So you've been since August.
Yes.
Every day?
Every day.
Serving meals. How many people are you serving typically?
On a good day?
Yeah.
200.
Is that a good day or is that a bad day, right? I mean, I understand what you understand.
Yeah.
It's a two-edged sword, right?
Yeah. So we went from almost 350 over the summer, though, because, you know, everybody's out. The homeless community is actually out and moving around.
So there were 350?
We were doing 350.
Oh, my goodness.
From September through October.
How in the world did you feed 350 people? I mean, where did it come from? Because that hundreds of pounds of meat that you had that was going to spoil in your freezer didn't last long, right?
Day 10.
Day 10, you're
done.
Day
10. We're at Sam's Club, and we're coming up with a plan. There was no plan. There was no plan.
Flying by the sea, that's called the Holy Spirit too, right? Hello,
so we got down to the bridge, and we set up, and this is our last day. Mm. Our dimes are gone. All our meat is gone.
Everything was gone, right?
Everything we had to make sure that we were be able to take care of our own kids.
That's right, because you still had to take care of your own family, right?
We still had to take care of our, and we didn't have lights yet. Day 10, we didn't have lights.
Yeah.
A lady came, and she gave us a check not a check. She gave us an envelope with $250 in it.
Wow.
Just to say thank you.
Wow.
And it was just the most amazing feeling just to know that somebody appreciated what we were doing and wanted us to be able to help.
Amen. Now, I bet you've heard the story of it was the story of the fish and the loaves in the Bible where Jesus, remember that story?
Yes. Yes.
And I know that there are people who hear that story and they think, oh, that wasn't real. I mean, it was just, here is a living representation of a Bible story that many times all of you, me too, have thought, oh, that isn't possible. Because eventually that $250, that was gone, wasn't it?
No.
What happened next?
We actually met some of the ladies from the church.
Yeah.
And they started bringing us ice.
Yeah.
Because it was, you know, 90 degrees outside.
90 degrees and it's hot. Yeah,
it was hot.
And you just,
it was hot.
Yeah.
And then people started showing up with meat. People start showing up with canned goods. People start showing up with water. And then a gentleman from Mercy showed up. And he was in tears. He couldn't even speak. Mm. He was an ER doctor from Mercy.
Amen.
And he and his friends raised money for us. And it was a check for $2,000.
Hallelujah.
It was, yeah, so we all stood outside in 90-degree weather and cried for about an hour together. Hallelujah. It was amazing.
See, isn't it? It is one of the most beautiful things when you actually give yourself over to being a vessel of the Holy Spirit, is that you think you're being a blessing to everybody else. Was that, as you sat out there, were you crying? Why were you crying?
It was just amazing.
It was an overwhelming sense of Holy Spirit,
yes,
wasn't it?
Yes.
Saying, this is what it feels like to have a purpose and a meaning, right?
Yes.
That's awesome.
It was more than awesome.
Yeah.
It was amazing. Yeah.
So you've been feeding people since August, but you're not just feeding people now. It's kind of grown, right? What else are you doing?
We are not just feeding people. So we have our Tuesday box distribution because one meal is going to settle you for the day.
Yeah.
But what if you can't get to us the next day? Or what if you can't find a means to get to somewhere to get a meal? So we give you a box of non-perishables and perishables.
Is it more than food, or is it, I mean.
So the Tuesday box distribution is generally food. So
okay.
Canned goods, bag of rice, bag of potatoes. We get thousands of pounds of meat. It'll be ground beef or chicken, or we do beef roasts. It's always good meat.
Wow.
We try to give people enough to work through a week.
Do most of the folks that come, do they have a place where they can even open a can or that
most of the people that come, yes.
They do, okay.
Most of the people that come
yeah.
are just lower income. They make too much to be able to get food assistance. Mm-hmm. And a lot of pantries and a lot of places in town, you have to qualify for those food
right.
boxes.
Right.
So if you do make too much, they'll turn you away, which is sad.
Sad, right?
If I didn't need it, I wouldn't come to ask for it. For you to tell me that I made $10 too much this paycheck, now I don't qualify.
Yeah. You're not asking those kind of questions.
We don't ask those questions.
If you need us, we're here for you.
We're going to give it to you.
So tell us exactly where you guys set up. You set up in the same place every day. So where is it?
It's on the corner of 8th Avenue and L Street.
So right underneath the overpass, right?
Right under the overpass.
Yeah, you guys all know where that's at? You've been familiar with that?
If you've been to the Flying Weenie, you can't miss us.
Yeah. And what time are you typically there?
In the summer, we were there all day.
But since
it's cold, we try to get there about 1, set up, have meals going by 3, and pack out by 6:30, just because it's so dark and so cold.
Right.
Yeah, we can't risk people coming out in the night.
So since it's been so cold, I was thinking about you guys this week. I thought, well, how do you do that? Do people just come and receive the food, and then they go back home, or they go?
Yeah, they go back home.
Yeah,
it's been miserable. And for a few days, we actually put posts up and said, don't come out. We know you might need it. We know it might help, but we'd rather you be safer on the roads than something happened to you out there.
Yeah.
And then after 2 or 3 days, we realized that
they were coming anyway.
Yeah. So we would see them come, and we weren't set up. So we just decided, if you can and you need it, we'll be here.
Yeah. Just knowing that you're going to be there. So it struck me, and I'd be interested to know, I bet you guys are developing relationships like community. I mean, you've probably seen some of the same faces every day now for months, right?
Yes.
So can you tell us a story or two about somebody that you've met that has been... I didn't give you this question ahead of time, I'm sorry.
I mean, there's a lot of moms that come. There's a lot of older gentlemen that come that live alone.
Yeah.
People
who don't even, they may not even have anybody else, right?
Yeah.
So you coming down there is like, these are my friends. You may be the only people that they talk to all day long, right?
Yeah, and that is a lot of the case because people will come and they'll kind of just linger.
Yeah.
If it's warm enough, they'll open their box and they'll start eating and
just
tell you about their day,
yeah.
You know? Because they might not have a companion that they can talk to. They might not have a friend. Everybody's closed in and not coming out.
Amen.
Some people we have come don't have phones. So when they do come out, they just want to chat.
Amen.
You know?
So I want you guys to hear this. See, as we were created in the image of God, right? And God created us for relationship. So when we are called to serve, where it's not just to hand out a hamburger. It is called we are called to be Jesus. And even though the primary purpose is to feed the body, you're feeding the soul. Relationships that are being built are going to be some of the most lasting things that occur as a result of what God's called you to do. Isn't that kind of cool?
Yeah.
Yeah. So how's it been with your kids? I didn't ask you, I didn't write this down either, but have they been all in on it, or are they, tell me about that.
They put up with it. They put up with it. The younger ones, they love it.
Yeah.
They tell their friends at school about it. They tell their teachers about it. We actually had a few teachers donate to us for Christmas, which was phenomenal. Mm-hmm. The older ones don't mind too much. They have to spend more time with their siblings, which is the best part.
Yeah.
So.
Awesome.
Yeah.
How long when the Good Morning America did a story on you guys, right?
Yes.
So, tell me about I went from the start to the whole thing. Can you tell us the story? Did you guys see the show or the spot on Good Morning America? Some of you did, some of you didn't, but go ahead.
So we had a call from someone from Good Morning, from ABC.
Yeah.
And she just wanted to do a story on Iowa.
So you were actually under the impression that they were coming to, just because of the derecho, it was a broader story, and that you guys were just going to be a portion of the story, right?
Yes, so. We were just going to help out with, you know, photos and things like that.
Yeah.
So I had been talking to them for maybe a month, and they sent a crew down, and they recorded us giving out our Tuesday food boxes,
which
was super awesome because Sam AOC actually came down from Starlight and donated burgers that day.
Awesome.
So we got to pass out burgers to the people.
Yeah.
And I want to say it was 2 or 3 weeks later, they said that they were going to come to the house and we were going to do a Zoom call, and they were going to just kind of talk to us a little bit about, you know, what happened in the storm and things like that. And when they showed up, they wouldn't let us leave out of the house.
So is that weird, or were you kind of like,
it was, they're like, no, we have cords everywhere. And I'm like, well, my neighbor just made me a cup of coffee. It's 6:05 in the morning. I just need something. I just need my coffee.
Yeah. And amen to that, sister.
They wouldn't let me go out and get my coffee. So he's like following me across the street. This is weird. Yeah. I don't see cords anywhere. Uh-huh. Okay. And I'm like, there's an ambulance parked underneath the bridge.
Ooh.
It was just a big truck with lights all over it.
Yeah.
I'm like, there's an ambulance parked under the bridge. They're like, no, it's fine. We don't know what that is. Okay. So we get in. We're doing our thing.
Were you thinking when you saw that ambulance, you think, oh, this might be one of my people, right?
I didn't know
that
what
somebody's
was going
hurt
on.
In trouble or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So maybe within an hour, we were doing our Zoom call, and all of a sudden we had to run outside, and there was a trailer in our driveway.
So it wasn't just any trailer,
it
right?
It wasn't any trailer.
Did you know what it was right off the top?
I did. I did know exactly what it was.
What did you think it was?
So the trailer had actually driven past us while we were on the road driving the day before.
Uh-huh.
And we're like, holy cow, that's such a cool trailer. Somebody's going
to
do
it. Wouldn't it be cool to have a trailer like that?
Somebody's
going
to open up a new food kitchen or food truck in Cedar Rapids.
Yeah.
That's so neat.
Yeah.
And it was actually on its way to get wrapped to say Bridge Under the Bridge. And we had just caught it right before that. So we would have caught it. No.
It was just an accident.
Exactly. Exactly. So, but it was amazing. It was amazing. It was one of the most, I have seven kids. It was a really good day.
We practiced this a little bit ahead of time through emails and stuff. She wants to say, it was the most amazing. No, my kids were the most amazing.
My kids are really, yeah.
Yeah, you know, the kids kind of get to be old. I mean, they're old after a while.
I've had them for a while. This is like new stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's okay.
You got this food truck, huh? By the way, I don't know if you knew this or not, but some of us in our church were thinking, we started looking, we were trying to find something for you too.
Wow.
Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, we started looking around because Francis and Jolene's son kind of does some of that kind of stuff, and we were thinking, what can we do? Can we help out? And in the meantime, this happens. See, God got that handle already, right? Yeah. That's awesome.
It was so good.
Yeah. So how many meals do you think you've sold out of that thing? Or not sold, given away. How many meals have you given away out of that since then, you think? Just estimating.
50,000.
Oh, my God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. That's awesome. So.
Yeah. I'm so glad. It just keeps us warm. Because we were, on the 22nd of December, we were still outside.
It's probably changed everything in your vision for what this could be, too, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We're actually trying to raise enough funding and donations of stuff.
Like what kind of stuff? Tell me what you're looking for.
We're looking for batteries, flashlights, diapers, water, mainly.
Are y'all hearing this? Let's slow down just a little bit. Looking for batteries,
flashlights.
What else?
Diapers. Water. Anything. Anything you needed after the storm.
Think about that. Anything that you needed after the storm, the folks that you get to be Jesus to need it every day, right?
Yeah. We're actually taking a trip to Dallas. We're taking that stuff to Dallas.
When are you going? When are you leaving?
We plan on leaving on the 1st.
On the 1st of March?
On the 1st of March. Yeah. It gives us 9 days to collect everything.
Okay. So, folks, did you hear that? I'm kind of getting a little bit ahead of myself, but I don't want to miss this opportunity. You need to be praying about what God is asking you to do with them. Because they're leaving on the first, Lord willing, right?
We're leaving on the first.
So we can gather stuff here, and we'll make sure that we get it to them on the first, right?
That'd be awesome. That'd be good.
So what other things, just in general, are there things that you guys need? Are you guys okay?
We maintain. We always have.
Yeah. Well, what can we do then? What can we do? You just gave us a good list, and that being practical, being specific is very helpful. What other things can we do? Do you have a vision for bigger things that you feel God calling you to, but it just takes resources or whatever?
We have a lot of things going. I'm actually in a few different business classes to try to build myself up to make sure that I can be successful in this.
Are you hearing this now? Listen to this. Yeah, did you hear what she said? She goes, "What in the world? When are you taking business classes, girl?"
6 to 8, Monday through Thursday, in my car on a Zoom call.
Are you really? And you're taking these business classes because here, and you all know this anyway, but ministry is not a business; it's a calling. But there are business practices that will help you to be more efficient
and more
fulfilling
successful.
Of what you're supposed to be doing, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you mentioned earlier just resources. Are there other churches that are helping or supporting?
Not like indirectly, no.
Really?
No. It's just the two of us.
If you guys got friends that go to other churches, I'm not kidding. You need, that's part of your ministry, is to say to your friends that go to other churches, this is something we are called to be together, right?
Yes.
We are called to be together.
That is the number one goal for us. Just share.
Yeah.
Just share this information with someone else.
Yeah.
And it might even help them to know someone that needs help.
Absolutely.
It's not even about somebody that might be able to help. Somebody
because all of this is almost happening by the Spirit anyway, because other than sending the kids out with a sign that says free food, there hasn't been any marketing plan or anything, right?
No.
No. Anything else that you want to before I give that to you, I want you all to know that we have a bucket back there for a free will offering for their family. If you feel called to give towards just their family, maybe just to be a blessing to their family, or to give to the ministry, you guys can decide to do with whatever you want to do with it. I mean, when we say it's a love offering, we intend. It's given with love, and you do with it what you need. Okay?
Thank you.
Whatever
yes.
you need. But please, folks, before you leave, be praying about that. Give generously, and remember that we are the hands and the feet of Jesus together, and this family is our family. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, go ahead and clap. Good.
This, we hope, she will. The cooking lady here will take her family today for lunch or dinner and go out and have dinner on Prairie Bible Church, okay?
Yes, thank you.
So, y'all can take your seat for just 1 second, because I know that she has one other thing that she wants to, maybe several other things she wants to share, and you can share whatever you want. Time is yours, okay?
So, I just want to say thank you for inviting us. It has been a pleasure to meet everybody. Whoever I have not met, I would love to say, thank you to you personally.
After church, there's other things to be done after church, but I want you just to, if you would, you and your family, or any of them that are willing, maybe just go stand in the back and just
absolutely.
Let them love on you a little bit, okay?
I would love that.
All right. What else do you have to share?
I also want to say another thank you. I just want to say thank you for the ladies who used to bring us ice. You guys, you made us through. It was 105 some of those days under that bridge, and it was it was so worth it. It was always a pleasure to see the ladies pull up in those trucks with coolers and ice.
Yeah.
That was awesome. Yeah. But we also have brought our food truck.
So you've heard about this food truck, right?
Yep.
Well, it's out there.
We toted our food truck along. And my husband is actually preparing a brunch for everyone right now. So don't leave.
And
make sure you grab a bite.
I was talking with him before church, and he said he loves to cook, right? He's a great cook.
Yes.
And it's like God saying, this is your thing, Javonte, right?
Yeah.
This is your thing.
Yeah.
He wants to cook for you. He did cook for you. So don't you leave before you get, we're talking hamburgers and baked beans, right?
Hamburgers and baked beans.
Sounds like a deal.
And his signature baked beans, I have to say this, signature baked beans. The president of Metco, we helped them with a meal.
Yeah.
And he had never touched beans from a kid. He's like, I'm never eating beans.
Yeah.
We made him eat his beans.
Made him eat beans.
We made him eat beans. And he ate two portions of them. So.
Anybody here not like beans? You're not leaving until you get a bean.
You have to have the
beans.
You
have to have a bean.
You have to have them.
Yeah. Awesome. Anything else you want to share?
No.
All right. This is what we're going to do to conclude this thing. Go ahead. Oh, good question, John. If we were going to, for the love offering, should we just make it out Bridget Williams, or you want something else? Bridge under the bridge. Bridge under the bridge. You can write, if you want to write a check, make it out to that, Bridget Williams, whatever you want to do. Okay. Anybody else have any questions? Yeah.
I don't have a question, but I would just like to say, I have ate at Bridges, and the food is just phenomenal.
Amen.
And I have, they make this, and like you said, the baked beans are just...
You know, these folks are probably going to be start coming down there every night.
There's always enough.
Charge them if they do, though, okay?
There's always enough. There's always enough.
Oh, if you want to know more about Bridge Under the Bridge, literally, that you have a Facebook page called Bridge Under the Bridge.
Yes.
You find out about
it. And it's the rainbow. So if you see the rainbow, you're in the right spot.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yep.
Anybody else have any questions? Yeah.
Yes. Yes. So it's Bridge Under the Bridge 380.
Bridge Under the Bridge 380 for Venmo. I saw a hand back here. Yeah.
You can get a hold of me. I can leave my contact information for whoever would like it. Yes.
Is there specific kinds of food that you need, or it'll take whatever? So to answer your question, Bob, if there are things that you guys have, you know.
Yes. So if it's small quantities, we usually pass it out to different people that might.
Yeah, because it's going to go in the boxes probably, right?
But if it's like the large number 10 cans or a large quantity of meat, if we are not passing out at that time, we'll cook it.
Okay, awesome.
We'll, you can turn anything into something good.
Listen, folks, what we're going to do is I'm going to invite the rest of you. I want to kind of social distance as best we can, but at least stand up where you are, and if you just stay seated, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to say a prayer. Extend a hand towards her. I'm not social distancing, but I'll put my mask on while we do this, all right? So, and if anybody feels called to pray out, do it. I mean, I'm going to start the prayer, but if anybody feel called to pray out, do it as we pray over she and her family, okay? Lord Jesus, there is not a greater privilege that we have but to be the body of Christ together. And to be inspired by Bridget and Javonte and her kids. And I'm thankful, Lord, that she came and shared their story with us today. And we're praying, Savior, that your Spirit would move in a mighty and powerful way for the sake of the gospel and for the sake of all those people that we get to be Jesus for through her and her family and her ministry.
Thank you for Bridget, and thank you for Javonte and the three babies that are in that
Thank you, Jesus, for giving us meaning and purpose, giving us vision, grace, and truth. May we be a reflection of you in everything we do. I thank you for my sister, and I thank you for my brother, and for all these beautiful children. I ask that you would just pour out your blessings all over them for the sacrifices that they have made for the sake of the gospel. We love you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And everybody said,
amen.
Amen. Give them a round of applause. I'll take that. She's going to be back there in the back. You can go on back right now if you want. And so please stick around. Go on out to the parking lot and get a hamburger and some baked beans, and make sure you leave a love offering if God's calling you to do that. But we went over a little bit today. Did anybody mind? I hope not, because this is a Jesus moment. Thank you, brother. I'm going to turn it over to you.
God of justice, Savior to all, came to rescue the weak and the poor, chose to serve and not be served. Jesus, you have called us. Received, and now freely we will give. We must go live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. We must go stepping forward. Keep us from just seeing, move us into action. We must go to act justly. To act justly every day, loving mercy in every way, walking humbly before you, God. You have shown us what you require. Now freely we will give. We must go live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. We must go stepping forward. Keep us from just singing, move us into action. We must go.
Fill us up, Lord.
Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out, Lord. Sing that again. Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out, Lord. We must go live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. From just singing, move us into action. We must go, we must go. Live to feed the hungry, stand beside the broken. We must go, stepping forward. Keep us from just singing, move us into action. Send us out, fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out, Lord. Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up and send us out. Fill us up send us out, Lord.
Would you please bow your heads and pray with me?
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back.
Though none go with me,
though none go with me, I still will follow. Though none go with me, I still will follow. Though none go with me, I still will follow. No turning back, no turning back.
Dear Lord Jesus, there is no turning back. Once we've experienced your perfect love, once we've received you into our hearts and been filled with the Holy Spirit, we have no other choice but to love and to serve you. And you've called us to love and to serve you by reaching out to the least and the lost, whoever they may be, Lord. I know that in each of our hearts we have a person in mind, or maybe several people in mind, or maybe a ministry that you're calling us to love. And so we pray by the power of the Holy Spirit that you would enable us to do just that. Also help us to move the cause of the gospel, to share your gospel so that people might come to know you, Lord, and that your church might thrive, even here in Cedar Rapids. We pray and we ask all these things in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you so much for being here today. Have a blessed week.
differences. Together we are bolder, braver, stronger.
Jesus, there's nothing impossible.